It's getting toward the end of the day, so it's getting a little bit dark. I'm not sure how the light is going to look on the camera, but I wanted to take a few minutes to show you an old growth forest. Old growth is related to age, but it's also kind of a stage of development in a forest cycle. In the Pacific Northwest, in coastal British Columbia, many of the trees that we have here, especially the Douglas fir and the Western red cedar, can live to be many hundreds or even over 1,000 years. And so we can have these forests where, if they don't have a stand replacing disturbance, can continue to develop over a very long period of time. So there are some characteristics we look for in an old growth forest. First is having some really big trees. So that's one thing. But often we find the trees aren't all big because even though we might not have a stand initiating or stand replacing disturbance, there's constant disturbance in these forests where individual trees or small pockets of trees may die from fungus or disease or insects or small fires from wind throw. And so you have regeneration. So notice here, let's look. Okay, look in the direction I'm facing. Here's a big Douglas fir. This tree is probably almost a meter in DBH, so a big tree. And if I look around, so kind of look where I'm pointing here, if you can see here, I'll point here so maybe you can see my finger and what I'm pointing at. I see some more huge Douglas firs over there. I'm going to gradually turn around. I see a number of really large Douglas firs, probably in about the 50 centimeter to 1 meter DBH. So we definitely have big trees. But as you look, we have lots of small trees too. Let's walk over here for a minute. See, we've got some Western hemlock here. And this Western hemlock might actually be quite old. It's a small tree, but I wouldn't be surprised if we cut it down and found out it was 50 or 75 years old, or maybe even older than that, because it can be very long-lived in the understory, and if it's not getting a lot of light, it can just kind of hang on. And if we walk further down, we see okay, I'm walking up to a small Western hemlock. So see, we have a smaller tree here. If I look up to its canopy, it might be hard for you to see. It's not quite in the all the way up to the canopy, so it's a little bit in the understory. In the direction where I'm pointing, I see a big Douglas fir that actually looks like it has some fire scars on it. And next to it is a small hemlock. We've got a snag here. That's another really important component of an old growth forest. Snags, standing dead trees, and coarse woody debris. Coarse woody debris is dead wood that's on the ground. So that's another important characteristic that we expect to find in old growth forests. Look at this tree over here. I don't have my DBH tape on me. Well, first off, note that we're going through some very young hemlock to get here, so there's trees growing in the understory. Oh, this is a beautiful tree. I don't have my DBH tape on me, but that's got to be probably a meter or more in DBH. This is a monster tree. And I see, it looks like, I can't tell if it's just lichens. It looks like there might be a little bit of charring on the bark. Maybe it's just lichens, I can't quite tell. All right, so looking around again, just note, here, let me get to a spot where you can see. Okay, I'll pause for a second. Just look around. Note that we have a few different species of trees. We have some huge trees, and we have plenty of small trees. So we have diversity in sizes of trees. And that doesn't just go for DBH, but that goes for, goes for the vertical layers in the forest too. So sometimes in a forest, in a very dense forest, all of the trees are the same height. But in an old growth forest, we expect a high vertical diversification. We expect there to be a lot of foliage at the top of the canopy, but some trees are going to be very tall. I see a big Douglas fir over there that's quite tall. It might even be 40 or 50 meters tall. But I see some Western red cedar next to it that are probably only 60% as tall. And looking around, of course, we've got these saplings growing in the understory, saplings growing in the understory as well. So we have lots of vertical diversity in this forest. In old growth forests, we also look for horizontal diversity, meaning if I'm in one spot and kind of look around and see how it looks, and I move 100 meters in another direction, it might look quite different there. And that's because the disturbance in these forests is driven by these gap dynamics, these changes, these small disturbances that create gaps in the forest where you have lots of light. So it allows kind of a sudden pulse of regeneration, or trees like these western hemlocks that have been hanging out in the understory, or western red cedars, can suddenly have a burst of growth and grow higher and make their way up into the canopy. So in summary, the characteristics that we see in old growth forests are big trees, snags and coarse woody debris, a diversity of tree sizes, so big trees but also small trees that may be shade-tolerant trees growing slowly in the understory, or they may just be younger trees. We see horizontal diversity, so different areas of the forest can look quite different from one another. And we see vertical diversity. Not all of the trees are at the same height in the canopy. We're going to have some trees towering above others, and we're going to have trees occupying those mid-layers in the canopy.